app is planning to invest $2 billion into Indonesia over the next 5 years. The Singapore-based ride-sharing firm is using capital that it received from Japan's SoftBank Group to fund its expansion into Southeast Asia's most populous market. SoftBank will help Grab build a second headquarters in Jakarta. In a statement, Grab said that the investment will go towards creating a transport network based on electric vehicles. The company also setting its eyes on other sectors. It plans to launch e-healthcare services to improve access to doctors and medical facilities. SoftBank put nearly $1.5 billion into Grab through its Vision Fund. Doubling down on Indonesia is set to intensify Grab's competition, of course, with homegrown rival Gojek. The two startups have evolved from ride-hailing app operators to one-stop shops for services ranging from payment transfers to food delivery. And for more on the impact of Grab and SoftBank's venture into Indonesia, we're speaking now to Nitin Pangarkar. He's an associate professor of strategy and policy at the NUS Business School here in Singapore, and he joins us now in the studios. Good evening, Nitin. Good to see you.
So the significance
of this Grab and SoftBank investment, how do you see it?
Good significance. It's good for Grab. They get more money. They get a reaffirmation of their strategy. You know, they're on the right track. They get to localize the services. So it's an important market. It's a growing market. So they get the resources to localize the services. So those are all good things. For SoftBank, it's another bet. And you spread the bets, you know, whichever way you come out ahead. You know, whichever company wins, you will come out ahead.
What about this issue of Grab doubling down on its expansion into Indonesia? Is it being seen as Grab going head-to-head with the local homegrown firm, Gojek?
I would tend to think differently. I think they're too smart to do that. I think Indonesia has a lot of what I call gaps in the market. So gaps in the market are where a particular segment is underserved, say, because of lack of infrastructure or lack of efficiency. So the potential is large. So you go into Indonesia because the potential is large. I don't think you go in there to neutralize somebody. You go in there because with a positive mindset that this is a market where there are many, many opportunities. It's a large consumer base as well, so there are many, many opportunities, and that's what you're going there for. I think in the process of, you know, serving that market, if you go head-to-head against Gojek, that's so be it. Mm.
So no potential significant advantage for Grab because of the SoftBank Vision Fund that it's part of?
They do get the money, right? And they do get the money. And with that money, what they can do is they can probably localize more. And every country will have different infrastructure, different customer needs, and different competitive scenarios. So what you can do is you can localize better if you're closer to the ground. So with that money, you can do better localization as such. So the Grab does get some advantage, and Gojek also has some advantage being the incumbent player in Indonesia. So, but there's a lot of room to run in Indonesia. So I think there's a lot of growth to be had. So I think both can really come out winners. It's not necessarily only one.
What I hear you say, Nitin, is that more competition is better in this case. Will the Indonesian consumer benefit?
Absolutely, yeah. I think more competition always benefits consumers. Some companies might lose out and some companies might win, but the consumer almost always wins because of better services, lower prices, more innovation, and so on.
So the technology sector for Indonesia, it has huge potential. Of course, it's Southeast Asia's largest market. So
right.
How do you see SoftBank's input here, this interest that it has in terms of this injection of funds?
Right. I think SoftBank is there to give the support. And I think the technology by itself is not difficult, but I think what Grab can do is, being closer to the ground, they can probably develop the technology better, with and SoftBank can give the support if needed. Yeah, I think, but I think it's not like rocket science technology which has to come from Japan or somewhere else. It can be developed in Indonesia.
And SoftBank is also making this injection of funds into Tokopedia, apart from Grab as well. I mean, what's your view on
that? I think e-commerce is a booming market, and many of us, including, you know, regardless of nationality, regardless of our income levels, we're shifting to online purchasing. So Indonesia would be a booming market. So I think e-commerce is going to be the trend of the future. So why not place another bet on the e-commerce and, you know.
And what about this move? What does it spell for Grab's plans in the region? It's been diversifying a great deal. It's even gone into money lending to some extent as well.
Right. So I think they want to be, as you said earlier, they want to be a multi-service company and a multi-country company. So they are into Vietnam, they are into Indonesia, they are into Singapore, they are into Malaysia and so on. So clearly there is benefit to having a regional presence, and the more services you can offer, I think the more your catchment area is, the more you can keep the customer as well. You know, if you can sell the customer a range of services, they are far more likely to stay with you than go elsewhere. So I think that's another reason for offering a broad suite of services.
And it's spending big to do so. Nitin, thank you very much for coming into the studio to
thank
share
you,
your perspectives on this story with us. I've been speaking there to Associate Professor Nitin Pangarkar from the NUS Business School.
Thank you, Don.